Hello everyone, I am Rishikesh Singha Reddy. I hail from Kadapa, Andhra Pradesh. I have done my graduation from IIT Delhi in Electrical Engineering. I secured an All India rank of 95 in Civil Services Examination 2019. My optional subject is Electrical Engineering. This was my fifth attempt, and I have in all my five attempts, Electrical has been my optional. I wanted to share a few things about the book list which I referred to and what are the changes in the topics which I have made, and also how I went about preparing this. Before that, I have given four mains, and this was my fourth main. And last year in 2017 attempt, when I have cleared, I got 347 in electrical, which was highest score in electrical. And in the previous two attempts, I scored an average of 250 in both attempts. The scoring pattern was less on those, but still I was able to improve my score from 250 to 347. I will suggest some of the ways how I have done that, and I will also give you a book list in the video. So to start with, Prakash Raj Purohit sir, rank 2 in CSE 2009. So I have relied mostly on his book list, but I also supplemented from other sources, because as the preparation changed from one topic to another, so I as there were new additions with the questions which have coming from, so I have also referred to my own books in the further attempts. I have changed some of the books of Prakash Raj Purohit sir, and I have added my own.
For UPSC CSE aspirants, I have a good news. An academy has brought new UPSC CSE batches, which will be starting from the 25th of January. These batches are in 6 months, 1 year and 2 years, and the batches will be completing your UPSC preparation. The 25th January batches will offer you a complete GS syllabus with 500 plus hours of live classes, free PDF study material, a structured schedule, and a doubt clearing session from An Academy's top educators. Batches will be conducted in bilingual, that is Hindi plus English, Hindi language and the English language. So what are you waiting for? Enroll now for the 25th January batches. To enroll in the batches, you can click on the link mentioned in the description, download the An Academy app, and as per your preparation, select your batch. To get an instant 10% off, use the code DKT10. Don't wait for anything. Get your enrollment now and complete your preparation with An Academy. Let's crack it.
So I will be telling my own strategy. First, I will come in paper 1. I will tell the basic books I have used. In the paper 2, I will tell the basic books I have used. And then I will talk about brief suggestions which you need to follow. So in paper 1, there are 8 topics. So first, let's deal with the circuit theory. For circuit theory, the focus should be on solving as many number of problems. It's an easy topic. And you can refer to any book which has a basic things which are covered in the syllabus. I have referred to A. Chakrabarty. It covers, it is a Dhanpat Rai publication book. So it covers almost all the topics, which are given under circuit theory. In this chapter, try to focus more on network theorems and two-port networks and the graph theory, which is more important. But generally, people tend to ignore these topics. Most of the questions come from these topics itself. So try to do that. Second topic is signals and systems. I have used Sanjay Sharma as my primary book. It's an Indian author. And then I have used Oppenheim as my secondary book. Oppenheim is a foreign author. So they both cover the syllabus very well. Sanjay Sharma alone covers the syllabus really well in this. So if you have time, also go for Oppenheim. But there is one topic which is not covered by both the books, that is DFT and FFT. So you just go to YouTube, search any video about DFT, FFT. You will definitely get a basic understanding of DFT. It's a complex topic, DFT, FFT is. But try to have a basic understanding of what DFT and FFT. No question has been asked till date, but it may be asked. That's why you have to be very sure in covering all the topics. And also one important thing to note in signals and systems is the formulas in signals and systems are very lengthy. They can be very confusing. There are so many number of formulas. So have a sheet of paper, write down every formula and then revise them. Third topic is EM theory. You don't have to do anything beyond Sadiku for this. Electromagnetism by Sadiku. So that is a very good book. And even in that, you don't have to do every chapter. Only in chapter 9, 10 and 11. They will cover your entire syllabus. try to solve all the solved examples from this book. You don't have to do anything else apart from that. Then the fourth chapter is analog electronics. I refer to a book named J.B. Gupta, Analog Electronics by J.B. Gupta. So it is a very good book, but it is very extensive. The syllabus is also very extensive. So do it very patiently and then try to solve all the solved examples in the book. Apart from this, as the questions are more from analog electronics, I took ESC material of ACE. ACE is a coaching institute. You can take ESC material of ACE or you can take ESC material of MADEEZY. So both of these are primary good institutes for ESC examination. So you can take any of their books and then you can solve problems from that. Then the fifth topic is digital electronics. I have referred to Maurice Mano for this. This is a very good book again. So this covers all of your syllabus. Apart from that, again, as more number of questions come from this topic, I have also solved problems from ACE material, ACE ESC material, which they give for mains. There is one topic in this, 555 timers and comparators. They are not covered in Maurice Mano. For that, refer to any book. I have referred to J.B. Gupta. You don't have to refer to just that. You can refer to any book. Then energy conversion is the sixth topic. I have referred to Ashfaq Hussain for this. So in this, this is again a good book. It covers entire syllabus. Cover all the solved examples from this. So if you are short on problems, try to take up, as I said, ACE material, ACE mains material or MADEEZY material. Then coming to seventh topic, power electronics and electrical devices. So I have referred to P.S. Bimra for it. This is a very good book, but the problem is it is a very huge book. It takes a lot of time. And sometimes the number of questions are also high. But in some years, the number of questions are low. But so you can't take that choice. So you have to give... complete the book thoroughly. You don't have to do every chapter. So for example, you have to do chapter 2, chapter 4, chapter 5, chapter 6, chapter 7, chapter 8, and chapter 12. So sometimes what happens is they directly pick the solved examples from these chapters and directly they lift the questions directly even without changing numerals. So you have to be very good in power electronics in this. Second, you don't have to refer any other book. P.S. Bimra is sufficient for this. The eighth topic in paper one is analog communication. So I have referred to Simon Hakin and B.P. Lathi, but the problem is they do not cover the syllabus very well. So when I was searching, I found a very good NEPTEL course, which is online. So I will give a link to my blog in which I have posted all the PDFs from the NEPTEL course. They cover your syllabus in entirety. So just go through those PDFs. There are 6 PDFs. So these PDFs will cover you. If you think that you have not solved enough problems, then please refer to ACE ESC material again. Now let's come to paper 2. So control systems is the first topic. For this, I have referred to FF Core. This is a very good book. It covers all the examples and also the theory part of CoA is very important. Last year, there were certain bouncers in control system, but they also have been covered by FF CoA. So very thoroughly, you complete this book. Focus on examples, solved examples. There are not many in solved examples, but whatever it is given, thoroughly do it. And there is, in this, for solving more and more problems, there is a book by Technical Publications, Control Systems. I don't exactly remember the author. I have posted it on the blog. So it comes from Technical Publication source. So Technical Publication. So you try to refer to that book. The second topic is microprocessors and microcomputers. So I have referred to a book called Ramesh Gonkar for it. It is very easy read. The book is, you can complete it very easily. And it is more or less comprehensive in the syllabus. But there are some small portions of peripheral devices which are not very well covered. So try to do something away from Gonkar, whatever book or either internet is fine for this. And one important thing you have to do for this topic is try to cover previous year's questions of both engineering services and civil services, because sometimes they tend to pick from the past year threats. So just don't miss out on those. The third topic is measurement and instrumentation. So for this, there is a huge book called Shawnee, but I don't think Shawnee is very important. I think you can do with, there is a Made Easy Written Notes, book by Made Easy. It is a written notes. So they cover almost all the topics except for two topics. Which is spectrum analysis and signal condition. For those two topics, please refer to Shawnee, because they are not covered very well any elsewhere. So please refer to spectrum analysis, signal conditioning, Shawnee. Or one thing you can do, if you think Shawnee is a very big book, you can do spectrum analyzer and signal conditioning from measurement and instrumentation of technical publication. Technical publication is a very good source. I also mentioned technical publication for control systems. Also for measurement and instrumentation, there is a measurement and instrumentation by Uwe Bakshi. So they have written a book for this. So that is a very good book, and it covers spectrum analyzer and signal conditioning very well. So if you can get a hold of this book, this is a very good book. I have updated that on the blog also. Fourth topic is power systems. There is only one book you have to refer to, Nagrath Kothari. Do all the solved examples of the book. And if you have time, then pick up Vadva. And then complete all the solved examples. Vadva is a different book. So try to complete Vadva there. You don't have to do anything else up for power system. Then power system protection. Again, there is only very good book, Badriram and Vishwakarma. There is no need of referring to any other book. It covers entire syllabus. But there is one problem. When it comes to power system protection, more number of questions come from circuit breakers and digital protection. So never ever neglect this circuit breaker and digital protection questions. One thing I wanted to add, last year there was a 10 marker and it was directly picked from Badriram and Vishwakarma, the book I just said, without even changing the examples. So even the values were not changed, it was directly asked. It was a solid example from Badriram Vishwakarma. The sixth topic, digital communication. This is a very, very dicey topic. And one good book for this is technical publications. I have already said technical publication for control systems and for measurement and instrumentation. Technical publications for digital communication is must. It covers entire syllabus very, very well. And except for seven-layered architecture. For seven-layered architecture, refer to Forrison. Just chapter 1 and 2, it covers data networks and 7-layered architecture. Because 7-layered architecture, they're not asking many questions, but sometimes they may get 10 markers from there. So this completes all my book list. So it is a very comprehensive book list. So almost you have to refer to 17 to 18 books for this. So I understand that's a difficult proposition, but still that is bare minimum amount which you have to do if you want to complete the whole of electrical syllabus. But once if you complete this, this optional has very good rewards. As I said in my earlier video also, this optional gives you very good strike rate and very good rewards after the examination. I got 347 in this, and only because of that optional score, and despite a low interview score of 135 in 2017, I was able to make it to the final list. So I think this gives that advantage over other options. So this is one thing I wanted to highlight in this. I have put all these books, if you have missed any of the book which I've said, I have put all of them in my blog. So you can go to the blog, you can see I have written all these down in my blog also. I'll give a link of the blog below. So you can go and view it there. Now I wanted to tell a certain few general suggestions on how to do well in this optional, apart from the books. So first thing you have to do is that you have to ensure that you cover every subtopic which is there in the syllabus. Do not never leave out anything. One of the biggest mistake I did in 2016 was when I did not clear my mains, that I left many subtopics. I did not prepare those subtopics very well. And almost 60 to 70 marks in just one paper came from those subtopics. I was very clueless about them. So I just got a very bad score of 250 at that time. So in 2017, I completed everything, and then that increased my score from 250 to 347. Second thing is, do not neglect solving problems. Solving problems is very, very important. Every day, whatever the amount of time you put for your optional, especially for electrical or your technical optional, so never ever neglect problem solving. Always focus on problem solving. If you are putting 4 hours put 2 hours for problem solving, because ultimately out of the 500 marks you have to attempt, 400 to 420 marks will be your you have to solve problems. So this will, as you solve more number of problems, your accuracy will improve and your silly mistakes will go down. Even in the last year paper, I made silly mistakes for almost 50 marks. If I had not made those marks, I would have got even better score last year. I mean, 2019 attempt. I do not know what my score is, but I made a silly mistakes of 50 marks despite making so many efforts, so much of calculation, so much of earlier attempt. So I think so silly mistakes will get your score down. Do not do that. So for that, you have to really, really solve problems more. And do previous year's questions of both CSC and engineering services. MadeEasy has come up with 16 years solved papers for CSC and ESC. So you can just take the book. You have solved examples also. So it will also be a form of problem solving for you. Then the third thing, join a test series. There is only one test series for electrical, which is from Next IAS. No other institute has any test series. That is a very good test series. Use it. Try to correct your mistakes. Try to solve those tests within 3 hours so that you are able to, you know, get yourself into that group before the exam. Do not neglect theory part again, because sometimes what they do is they ask theory questions, like they ask what are the disadvantages and advantages of this motor, series motor, shunt motor, or they may ask you any theory question from anywhere. So do not neglect theory part apart from problem solving. Then note making. I think one of the best thing I have ever done was note making for my electrical engineering. I have not put my notes for electrical engineering in online domain, because those are physical copies. I will try to digitize them as soon as I can, and I'll try to give access to it. Because the syllabus is very huge and the books are very huge. So if you just rely on books and if you try to revise the book every time, you will go nowhere. So what I used to do was, I used to take some bundle of 40-50 pages. I used to pin them. And every topic I used to finish all the solved examples, all the important theory bits, all the important derivations I should remember. Everything I used to put in the 40-50 pages. So around I used to have around 600 pages, around not 600 pages to around 400 pages in entire for my electrical. All for entire electrical, which I had to revise before exam. So I get 1 week time after my GS 3-4, and in those 1 week time, I revise all those 400. You're good to go. You'll be very good in your preparation. So note making in that is very important. Even after I give my notes, you should have your own notes, which you can avoid. Then please avoid silly mistakes. As I said, you know, that you can only avoid silly mistake when you practice more and more. So this is what I wanted to tell. And you know, be shrewd in the way you attempt your question. Sometimes what happens is, for example, a 50 marker is there, you have, and you know 40 marks out of it, and you can solve the 40 marks really well, like perfectly correct. But there is another question in that you know all the 50 marks, but there is a chance that, you know, a 15 marker may go wrong because you're not very sure of it. In that, I would suggest you attempt the 40 marker in that the first one where you know the 40 marks very well and you leave out the 10 marks, because I will give you a good insight in this. When I got 347, my correct attempt was around 415. Out of 500, my correct attempt was 415 and they awarded me 347. So it's not like in electrical you have to do all 500 out of 500, right? No, it's not like that.
For UPSC CSE aspirants, I have a good news. Unacademy has brought new UPSC CSE batches, which will be starting from the 25th of January. These batches are in 6 months, 1 year and 2 years, and the batches will be completing your UPSC preparation. The 25th January batches will offer you a complete GS syllabus with 500 plus hours of live classes, free PDF study material, a structured schedule and a doubt-clearing session from Unacademy's top educators. Batches will be conducted in bilingual, that is Hindi plus English, Hindi language and the English language. So what are you waiting for? Enroll now for the 25th January batches. To enroll in the batches, you can click on the link mentioned in the description, download the Unacademy app and as per your preparation, select your batch. To get an instant 10% off, use the code DKT10. Don't wait for anything. Get your enrollment now and complete your preparation with Unacademy. Let's crack it.
So when you can have a leverage of 70 to 80 marks, if you are able to attempt 420 correct, so I think you can get a very good score of around 350 easily. So if you are getting 420 right, so focus on this. So ensure that whatever you are attempting it really well. So this ends most of my suggestions to you on what my book list is and what you should be doing. So in the end note, I wanted to say, like, this optional can be very, very exhausting, but at the same time, this can be very rewarding. Because even in 2016, after I couldn't clear Mint, then I felt that should I leave the optional, should I take another thing? But I felt that no, I should stick to it because I already spent time. And also, as I said, it is a rewarding optional if I do it well. So I stick to it. You know, there are phases when you want to give up. So do not do that. Always, you know, when you have taken it, be consistent. It may not help you in one attempt, but I am very sure it will help you in other attempt. Because electrical, one advantage is there is no dynamic part to it. There is only static portion. So you don't have to update yourself. Once you have completed the syllabus, you're good to go for any number of attempts, unlike other optionals. And also, once you have done a basic amount of preparation, good focus, it will fetch you marks. So on this note, I end this video. I wish you very, 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 very best for those who are taking this optional. It's a good optional, and all the best for your preparation.